And that former teacher's aide is Talik Brooks. And yes, among the charges that he faces is recording child porn videos in classrooms at this elementary school. Now he is being held without bail in regard to those charges. And as more possible victims come forward, thanks to this teacher's aide's own computer fingerprint, more suspects may be captured as well. Teacher's aide Talik Brooks has told FBI agents he used his 1,000-plus computer files of child porn to pleasure himself, but were others involved in the making of child porn videos in classrooms at the school where Brooks worked and then distributing those videos? That's what the FBI agents at PS 243 are looking into now. In their criminal complaint, investigators said Brooks engaged in this peer-to-peer or P2P child porn file sharing.
Technically, when you share peer-to-peer, you give access to the people in your peer network to just download or upload files to your computer.
Computer forensics expert Joe Caruso points out that in order to do peer-to-peer sharing, a computer user like Talik Brooks has to have peers, other people receiving and sending smut from the computer of the school worker so trusted that he was able to play the Easter Bunny at school. Other equally trustworthy people could be involved in the child porn sharing and making that Brooks is charged with.
They had access to his files. They could have downloaded them or uploaded them to his machine. So they were, in fact, trading files.
So other people may have poisoned the prospects of an untold number of innocent kids. The questions now, who are these other suspects, and do they have a connection also to this school?
He was hit in his private.
A mother at the school yesterday told us that Brooks and at least one other teacher may have physically abused students. The mother has called a special FBI number the school handed out, and the agency says it's been getting more calls. And this is being handed out here at the school about a community meeting on Saturday with a former child sex crimes prosecutor. Let's make one other point in closing, and that is this. That computer expert points out that these child porn files, once they get out there, they're there possibly forever. So some of these innocent kids could end up becoming adults to find themselves somewhere on the World Wide Web in a way they just did not ask for. Reporting live from Crown Heights, I'm James Ford, PIX 11 News.